Okay, let's do this. Welcome to our first webinar after the summer break. We are very delighted that you could join us today. And let's dive right in. Do you know what is toxic, smelly, and can even destroy concrete? That's right. Today we'll be talking about hydrogen sulfide, or in short, H2S. It's a colorless gas that is not only highly toxic to humans and smells extremely unpleasant, H2S is also a real threat to our wastewater systems. The results of H2S are costly, consequential damage, and remediation. But how can we effectively combat this invisible threat from afar? That's what we will be talking about today. Let me shortly introduce myself. My name is Anna and I've been a partner manager at Microtronics for 3 years now. And with me today is my colleague Marcel.
Hi, my name is Marcel Ortler and I'm from the Technical Support Center and I'm here at Microtronics for 2 years now.
We have already organized a couple of webinars on sewers and the harsh environment. And my colleagues are going to post a link to the recordings in the chat right now. So if you want to watch those, they are still available on our website. So what are we looking at today? We'll be talking about the problems and challenges caused by hydrogen sulfide, how we can easily control H2S remotely. And then Marcel is going to show you what this all looks like in practice on our platform. Our webinar is going to take approximately 15 minutes a day, and then we will have time for questions in the chat or the Q&A section. So if you come up with questions during the webinar, you can already post them in the chat or in the Q&A section, and we will take a look at them after the webinar.
Yeah, but why is H2S so dangerous? Have you ever noticed the unpleasant smell of rotten eggs as you walk through the city? Then hydrogen sulfide was probably the culprit. The pungent odor is caused by high level of H2S in wastewater and sewage systems. But the unpleasant smell is only the beginning. H2S can be very dangerous. Possible hazards are adverse effects on humans and environment, risk of explosion, and corrosion of infrastructure. But first of all, Anna, what are the effects of hydrogen sulfide on people and the environment?
So H2S is not only the unpleasant smell that Marcel just mentioned, it is a highly toxic gas with serious consequences for humans depending on the concentration. At low concentrations, typically around 0.00047 ppm in ambient air, we perceive the smell of rotten eggs, as mentioned, and the gas can also irritate the eyes, nose, or throat. It becomes dangerous at concentrations of around 100 to 150 ppm. This is because then the sense of smell is already dull, so the gas and the associated danger are no longer perceived. At very high concentrations above 700 ppm, H2S quickly causes unconsciousness and death within just a few breaths. So the gas is also very toxic to plants and animals in high concentrations. It can be particularly harmful to fish and other animals in the water.
But hydrogen sulfide is not only toxic, it is also highly explosive. It's a dangerous combination. Even a small amount of H2S in the air can form explosive mixtures that can be catastrophic at the slightest spark. Especially in confined spaces such as sewers, the heavy gas accumulates, literally waiting on an opportunity to explode. A harmless ignition source and the invisible gas becomes a devastating fireball. H2S is therefore not only a poison, but also a ticking time bomb that can go off at any time.
It is also an invisible threat to our sewers. The toxic gas is produced in low oxygen conditions and attacks both metals and concrete. Particularly in damp, stagnant areas, specialized bacteria converts H2S into aggressive acids that break down concrete and literally eat away at metals such as steel and iron. The result, cracks, leaks, and structural damage that are not only expensive to repair, but can also be really dangerous. Without preventative measures and regular maintenance, our wastewater systems could literally fall apart, so to say. How can we prevent this? How can we combat H2S from afar?
Good question. Here is one solution for that. A typical H2S monitoring system in a sewer might look like this. First, you have to measure the hydrogen sulfide concentration in the duct with an ATEX data logger and the integrated H2S sensor, which you can see in the middle of the picture. You can configure the device remotely via the IoT platform. The data collected in the duct is regularly transmitted to the platform via mobile radio and is available for reporting. You will be alerted immediately if a defined level is exceeded. Automatic dosing control for appropriated chemicals is also possible. As you can see on the left side with the dosing system and the C3. And record-keeping reports can be automatically generated and sent as PDF files. This reduces the time and effort required for the data processing and achieving.
So let's have a look at the ideal ATEX data logger. If you need to monitor the concentration of hydrogen sulfide in the sewer, then this rugged ATEX data logger is for you. The data logger provides you with live data from the harshest environments and achieves a battery life of 10 years with a 1 minute sampling interval and 4 hours of data transmission. In addition to hydrogen sulfide, you can also measure other things like hydrogen peroxide, for instance. Thanks to the innovative exchange concept, sensor replacement is very quick and easy. You drive to the measurement point with the new sensor model and replace it. The old module is sent in for calibration and then can be used again. So you do not have any data gaps and you do not waste any resources.
As Anna mentioned, here is the MyDataSense, and you can plug and play the sensor model. And it's that simple. You put it in and it works again.
So we've already told you a lot of theoretical facts. Marcel, can you show us how this all works in practice and what it looks like on the platform?
Sure. Need to have to search my window. So here's our server, the MyDataNet platform. You can see I have H2S data logger, the MyDataSense here. It's already in use since 2017, so it's a long time. When we go inside to the measurement data, you can see the H2S value. Measured in ppm, parts per million. And here you have your chart, and you can look up at any time at which time what H2S concentration was in the sewer system. So when here are the configurations. For example, here you can see that the sensor needs a calibration. So for that, just take a sensor, plug it out, send it to us, and take your new one. And we talked about the pump control. Here has a have a little example for that, where you can set the thresholds at what time that the pump controller should pump some chemicals into the sewer system. And that's the practical input. I'll change back to the presentation.
Thank you, Marcel. So let me quickly summarize how you can control H2S remotely. So the first step, of course, is you measure the hydrogen sulfide concentration at regular intervals and transmit the values to a central platform, as Marcel just showed you. If required, you can combine the monitoring solution with a dosing control. This can be either event-based, for instance, as soon as an odor is detected, or preventative, releasing chemicals to reduce the H2S concentration on a set schedule. And then thirdly, you receive an automatic PDF report on a daily, weekly, or monthly basis. You can customize that, and this significantly reduces your data processing and archiving workload. Control odors and corrosion, it's best to start now. So I think we gave you all the input that you need. By spring, at the latest, when the weather warms up again, odors will be back. So now is the time to think about it and inform yourself on it. If you're more interested or you would like an offer, just send an email to office@microtronics.com and we will get back to you as soon as possible. Questions, I would like to thank you for joining our webinar today. And we will for sure post about our next webinar, which is probably going to happen next month, on all of our social channels. So thank you very much and see you soon.
Thank you for your time and see you next time.
Bye.
Bye.